Welcome all. In this video, we are going to introduce the Nadir experiment, that is the determination of molecular weight of a non-volatile substance using the RAST method. For pure solvents like water, there are some characteristic features like the boiling point. You know that the water will boil at 100 degrees Celsius and the freezing point, the water will freeze at 0 degrees Celsius. Those values are constant and that will be the characteristic or unique feature of that particular component. This is the same for all the pure substances. They will possess some unique physical properties. When we are considering the same in the homogeneous solution means throughout that solution, concentration will be the same. So in those cases also, the value there will correspond a for that particular component, we will have a particular physical properties like boiling point, freezing point, etc. We know that the addition of an ideal non-volatile solute to a solvent won't change the chemical properties of the solvent. Rather, it will affect the physical, some of the physical property of the solvent. How it is doing that? It is changing the orderness of the solvent system, and or we can say that the disorderness of the system increases or the entropy is going to change. So this addition of solute to a solvent will lead to some of the properties like can lower the vapor pressure of the solvent, it can increase the boiling point of the solvent, lowers the freezing point of the solvent, and also can increase the osmotic pressure of the solvent. So these properties, which depends on the number of the solute particles or the properties which can alter by the number, not by the nature, that is called as a colligative property. And colligative means it's a term which means that depending on the collection particle solute molecules. And so in this experiment we are going to study one of the colligative property, that is the depression in freezing point. We know that the freezing point is a characteristic feature of a compound, and here we are going to see how the addition of a substance is changing the freezing point of a solvent. We are using the naphthalene as a solvent and adding camphor as a solute, and this colligative properties is used for finding out the molar mass of the substance. And Rajashree ma'am will be demonstrating this experiment for.
First, we have to find out the molar depletion constant of solvent naphthalene. For this, 5 gram of naphthalene is accurately weighed and transferred into a boiling tube. Now, it is kept on a water bath, a ring stirrer and a thermometer is kept on it. When the solvent completely melts, it is kept in an air jacket and the temperature is noted in every 30 seconds. After 30 seconds, it is 81. After 1 minute, it is 80. After 1 minute, 30 seconds, it is 79. After 2 minutes, it is 78.5. After 2 minutes 30 seconds, it is again 78.5. After 3 minutes, it is temperature is 78.5. The temperature is noted in every 30 seconds for about 2 more minutes. We have find out the melting point or freezing point of the pure solvent naphthalene. Now we have to find out the freezing point or melting point of the solution containing camphor in naphthalene. For that, accurately weigh about 0.5 gram of camphor and transfer it into the solvent. It is placed on a water bath. When the solution completely melts, it is taken out from the water bath and placed in an air jacket. The temperature is noted for every 30 seconds as we did previously. In order to plot a cooling curve, this process is continued for a few minutes. Experiment is repeated by adding 0.5 gram of camphor again to this solution, so that this solution contains 5 gram solvent plus 1 gram solute. Again, the cooling curve is plotted as described earlier. From these values, we can calculate the molar depression constant Kf for naphthalene. Now, we have to find out the molecular weight of unknown solute. This experiment is repeated by taking 5 gram of the solvent and 0.5 gram of the unknown solute.
So, by this experiment, we are validating the colligative property, the depression and freezing point, by taking the naphthalene as a solvent and adding camphor to it. And from that, we can find out the molar depression constant of naphthalene. Then, from that Kf value, we can find out the molecular mass of an unknown solute. We will get the Kf, we will have from this first part, and then we will do the second part, that the determination of molecular weight of the unknown non-volatile substance. And this equation connecting the freezing point depression and the molality is delta Tf is equal to Kf into m, and Kf is the molar depression constant, and it will be constant for a particular solvent. Molar depression constant or the cryoscopic constant is defined as a freezing point depression when 1 mole of the solute is dissolved in 1 kilogram of the solvent. Here we are going to see how this will have a solvent, it will have a freezing point, and on addition of a solute, the freezing point decreases. This then we had more of the solute, freezing point again decreases. This is what we are going to see. So this Tf minus T1 is a depression freezing point, and this equation connecting the freezing point depression and the molality is delta Tf is equal to Kf into m.
Thank you.